Hi, I'm Lauren DeBow, and today we're going to be looking at an exercise using the reformer that's going to incorporate some of our fascial elements. We're going to look specifically at a hip hinge pattern and how our breath can be incorporated into this. Andrea is going to help me demonstrate, and we're going to be using an SPX reformer today. So Andrea is going to be kneeling on the floor. If you're using a higher reformer, you can kneel on a padded platform extender or even on a reformer box. So we're going to start. Knees are going to be about hip distance apart. One hand will be resting on the foot bar and the other hand resting on the shoulder rest. So we're going to start the movement on an inhale. So it'll be an inhale to hinge forward, reaching out, and then exhale to return back to vertical. Let's do that hip hinge one more time. So hinging out, we're keeping a flat spine here, working on hydraulic amplification, and then exhaling to return back up to vertical, straight back. Now we're going to add some flexion. This is like the cat stretch. So it'll be an inhale to lengthen out all in one line on the exhale. Starting from the tailbone, curl up through the abdominals, and then press out again, flexing the spine, returning back to the neutral. Now the hinge again to come all the way back up to vertical. Let's try that again. Inhale to hinge straight forward, and then return back up again. You'll notice on the hip hinge, there's a little bit of an arm press going out. So inhale, reaching through the arms, that sense of hydraulic amplification, oppositional movements, and hinge back up to vertical. Now we'll add the flexion. So hinge forward in a straight line. Scoop the abdominals to flex up on the exhale. Keep the flex and then lengthen back out to the long line, hinging back up to vertical, all the way up tall.